It is a rare honor for the University of New Mexico and for the man who led UNM's geology department for more than three decades. His name on a map of the heavens forever. From now on, when someone looks at a map of the planet Mars, they will see a massive crater that would span from Grants to Albuquerque, named for the longtime head of UNM's geology department, Wolfgang Elston.
It makes me feel really wonderful.
Horton Newsom is a research scientist with UNM's Institute of Meteoritics. His team, with Elston's help, worked to identify and map places on Mars for the Curiosity rover to land in 2012.
It's really gratifying that we were able to get, he was able to be recognized in this fashion. It's quite an honor to have your name on another planet forever.
Elston died in 2016. With his work mapping Mars just a small part of his legacy.
Because of his dedication to New Mexico geology for his amazingly long career, generations and generations of students were trained at University of New Mexico by Wolf. And so this is a tremendous legacy of his.
Those students include Larry Crumpler, a grad student of Elston's in the 70s.
He was a kind of a down-to-earth sort of person who actually knew what it took to actually be a scientist.
Crumpler is on the staff of the Museum of Natural History. He is also on the team using the Perseverance rover right now to map Mars and collect rock samples.
Last time I saw Wolf, I actually thanked him because he actually made me into a field geologist, which I'm now using to own two different planets, because I still do it here on the Earth in New Mexico, but I'm doing it daily on Mars now.
Crumpler's book, Missions to Mars, is just out. It is the first time the Elston crater has appeared on a map in this form.
50 miles across.
That's Crumpler sharing the image with Elston's son, Steve. Steve Elston earned a physics degree at UNM, got his PhD at Princeton, and now teaches at Harvard.
Well, I was just thrilled because he had spent, you know, decades studying craters and working on lunar and planetary geology, and I knew he'd be thrilled, and it was just such a great honor.
All this from a man who, as a Jewish boy in his native Germany, fled Germany ahead of the Nazis, survived the Blitz in England at a school for refugees, and was reunited with his parents in the U.S. 7 years later.
To me, what was more remarkable about my father was he had gone through all that, you know, being run out of his country and barely escaping and then being bombed and, you know, everything. And yet he had this he was always optimistic. He was always ready to tell a joke. He was always ready to start the next big thing. And it, you know, never seemed to have dampened his spirits at all.
Just part of a remarkable legacy on this earth and beyond. Now, scientists at UNM are working on multiple Mars missions right now. They have collaborations with the Museum of Natural History, also with Los Alamos National Lab, as well as NASA.